higher than a deuce, lower than an ace. If you call it right, you'll win the race on Card Sharks. And here's the host of Card Sharks, Jim Perry.
Thank you, and welcome to Card Sharks. Thank you. You know, sometimes the audiences start clapping spontaneously along with the applause. I heard this audience. This is definitely not the Rockettes. That clapping was definitely out of tempo. We thank for the opening poem Patricia Gordon of Rosemont, Pennsylvania. Thank you, Patricia. Now let's get to the cards. Yannis and Bettina, start loading in the cards. We have a game in progress with these card sharks. Our champion, Willie Boston.
Hi, Jim.
He likes to be called Boston, I recall.
Right.
You are a teacher, sir.
Yes, I am.
And you won $1,600 on the last show, which is not too bad. Now, you said you are the best teacher.
Jim, I am the best that I know.
The best teacher you know.
Right.
Our challenger is also a teacher, Diana Jarrett. Hi,
Hi,
Diana. Nice to see you again. How do you feel about that?
Well, I just decided, well, he's just met me, so now we have co-best teachers.
Ah, you're gonna be even.
I'll be nice, yes. Oh. I'm the best third grade teacher. He can be the best high school teacher.
Oh, see great. How fair
that's
you're being.
Right.
Isn't that nice?
Oh, that's beautiful.
Now you're gonna go try to kill each other, right?
Right.
Right.
Good luck to both of you. You're nice people. Each player has a deck of 52 playing cards. They're shuffled, and the players cut them before we go on the air. Boston, the champion, plays the upper cards, the red cards. Diana, the challenger, the lower cards, the blue cards. Diana needs three cards. Boston has yet to turn over a card. And in the best 2 out of 3 match, Diana won game one. So the champion needs this game. And as we left off, Diana, the question goes to you. We asked 100 brides-to-be, and these are all women who plan to be married within the next 6 months. If you discovered your fiancé had been married before and had not told you, would you break off the engagement? How many brides-to-be said they would break off the engagement?
Oh, that's really hard to say. You know, how long had they been married and, oh, gosh. Oh,
that's interesting. That's a new wrinkle.
I'm going to go down the middle with it in 50.
50 would break off the engagement if they found out their fiancé had been married before.
Okay, Jim, I think that number would be high. I don't think they would break off simply because he had been married before.
No, how many said they would break off the engagement?
Oh, how many said they would break off the engagement?
They would break it off.
Oh, the number would be lower.
So you say lower.
Right, lower.
You think lower. They wouldn't? It really, I guess, depends on whether you go for whether you like the lying or the fact that they've been married before. It's tricky. Let's find out. The actual number of brides-to-be who, if they discovered their fiancé had been married before and hadn't told them, would break off the engagement is 22. It's lower, Boston. And your base card, Boston, is a king.
All right, all right. The next card is lower.
Lower than a king. Yes, a 9.
I'm going to freeze.
Freezing it right now. We've got a tie. Each player needs 3 cards. Boston, we asked 100 women who support the women's liberation movement. Do women gossip more than men? How many feminists said women do gossip more than men?
Well, that's quite high. Women know they gossip more than men. I think probably 72 would say they gossip more than men.
72 feminists
right.
said women gossip more than men, Diana.
I think it's going to be high, but I don't think it'll be that high because the feminists feel that men are too, you know, chauvinistic and all, and they're going to gossip. So a little bit lower.
Lower. The actual number of feminists who said women gossip more than men is 19. Very much lower, Diana. Yeah. You've got an 8.
Change it, please.
Whenever you win the question, you have the right to change it to
okay.
a queen.
Okay, good card. Lower.
Lower than a queen.
Oh.
Yes, a 10.
Okay, I am going to take a chance that it's going to be a lower card.
Lower than a 10. It is, no, it's another 10. It's not lower. A break for Boston to play off the 9 and call this.
Okay, Jim, the next card is lower.
Lower than a 9. No, it's a jack. Neither player could advance, and as we fill in the spaces, we are at sudden death. Someone has to win with this play of the cards. Diana, our man on the street went to Sydney, Australia, where he asked 100 married men Do you wear a wedding ring? How many Australian men said, yes, they wear a wedding ring?
Oh, I don't know the customs in Australia. But they're pretty, you know, they're pretty modern or up to date with what we are. So I would say it would be high. I would say 72.
72 wear a wedding ring.
Okay, Jim, I don't think it's really that many wear a wedding ring. I'm going to say the number is lower.
Lower.
Right.
The actual number of married men in Australia who wear a wedding ring is 55.
Yeah!
Boston.
Right.
Boston, you need 3 cards. Diana needs 3 cards. You've got the control. Do you want to play it or pass it?
Okay,
you got it, Diana.
That queen's
Diana,
a
if you
good
can turn them
card.
All over, you are the new champion. One mistake and Boston ties it up with a queen.
Okay.
What is this?
Next one, lower.
Lower than a queen. You're
right.
One third of the way there with a 5.
Good card. Higher.
Higher than a 5.
Oh!
It's a 7 now. Near the middle and a big decision.
All right. I'm going to say higher.
If this is higher, we have a new champion on Card Sharks. She won it. Three cards to win. Good job. And Willie Boston, I bet you are a good teacher.
Thank you. I'm the best.
And you're leaving us with $1,600.
Thank you.
Thank you for joining us.
Thank
bye-bye.
You.
Diana, come on down here. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Oh,
you're tall.
I'm tall, yeah.
Diana and I are going to talk for a while. You watch this. We'll play the money cards right after this commercial message. Back with our champion, the world's greatest third grade teacher.
Thank you.
You ready to go?
I sure am.
Then let's open the board and get to the money cards. Come on, Diana. Hop on up there. We've adjusted everything for your monstrous height.
Oh, thank you very much.
Diana, you won $200 in the game, yours to keep. New money to play with now on the money cards. With a new deck of cards, we'll give you $200 on the bottom level and these 3 cards to bet as you will. Move up to the second level, we'll give you another $200 in betting money and 3 more cards. Your minimum bets are $50 until you get to the top card, the big bet, where you must bet at least half the money.
Okay.
Come on, Diana.
Okay.
Let's do well. Here's $200.
Let's have some good cards.
I hope we can give them to you. We're going to give you one big advantage. We'll give you a choice of 2 base cards to start with,
okay,
and you can change the base card on each of the 2 succeeding levels. We'll start with a 10.
Oh.
You want it?
I think I'll change it.
Got to play this one. Next card off the top of the deck is...
Okay,
queen.
That's
okay,
better.
Better card.
All right, all of it. The next one is lower.
Whole thing right away. $200 lower than a queen.
That's
a 3, very much lower.
All of it lower.
What?
All of it lower.
All of it?
Higher.
You see, Diana, don't
sorry.
Get nervous.
Okay.
See, there are only a couple of deuces and 3s lower, you understand?
Right.
You can say it if you want.
Okay, right.
What do you want to say?
Higher.
Oh, higher. Okay, now.
I teach my third graders not too much lower than a 3, right?
Okay, so you say higher, and how
higher.
Much is
it? All of it.
The
400.
$400. Higher than a 3.
Oh.
Yes! With an 8, you double it to 800.
Okay, we'll be a little bit conservative on that 8, and let's go... 200 higher.
That's a big bet. You got a card right up the middle of the 8. She bets 200. It is higher than an 8. And she's right for an ace. Oh, yes. Up goes the big ace. 200 more dollars.
All of it lower.
$1,200 bet lower than an ace. Oh, no. Oh, no. Ah,
oh,
Diana, I'm sorry about that. My goodness.
That's too...
Well, maybe you get a chance to do it again.
I hope
you're
so.
The champion. Come on down here. You had to bet it that way, though, with an ace.
You have to with an ace.
Still got $200, though.
Right. Okay.
Which is better than a kick in the head.
That's right?
Right. We'll meet a new challenger right after this. That was awful. All set, Diana?
All set.
2 brand new decks of cards. And a new challenger on Card Sharks, Norma Brown. Hey, Norma.
How are you?
I'm fine. And you?
Fine, thank you.
Won't you tell us about yourself?
My name is Norma Brown, and I live in Iwakuni, Japan, via North Carolina, and I'm visiting here in California. I'm a professional junker, means I dig in other people's trash in Japan.
A professional? What does a professional junker do? I mean...
It means that we go out in the dark of night and go through other people's trash cans.
Is there much money in that?
Oh, yes.
Really?
Oh, yes.
Well, they sure got a lot of money over there, I can tell you that.
They certainly do.
Most of ours.
All of it.
Good to have you here, Norm. And you have picked up a bit of the Japanese accent, I can tell.
Oh, yes. I live in southern Japan.
Oh, good. Nice to have you here, Norm. You'll play the lower cards, the blue cards. Diana, the upper cards, the red cards. Diana, we asked 100 single women, have you ever dated a guy whose hair was longer than yours?
Oh, my goodness.
How many women said yes?
Oh, I think in the past couple of years, because of the long hair trend for women, or for men, and the short hair trend for women, that a lot would be. So I will say 48 half.
48 women have dated a man whose hair was longer than hers, Norma.
No, I do not agree, because younger girls would be single, and younger girls have longer hair, not short like we older women. So I'm going to go lower.
Lower than that?
Yes, uh-huh.
It's going to be fascinating, whatever the answer is. The actual number of single women who have dated a guy whose hair was longer than theirs is 41. It's just a little lower. Norma. That's still a lot. Norma, your base guard is a 3.
Oh, fantastic, Jim. Let's go all the way up.
Higher than a 3. Yes, with an 8.
Oh, let's freeze it.
Freeze it right there. Not going to give Diana a chance to play. And Norma, we asked 100 married men, if your mother-in-law stayed at your house for a month and ran up $200 in long-distance phone calls, would you ask her to pay the bill?
Most.
How many men said they would ask their mother-in-law to pay that $200 bill?
The old myth of we don't talk to our mother-in-laws went out the window a long time ago. They're going to ask for the money.
That's definitely talking to her, yeah.
So they're going to ask for the money. Let's go for 67. We'll ask for the money.
67 want that $200, Diana.
I think that's a lot of men will, but I think a lot of the wives would say, oh, come on, honey, she's only here for a month the whole year, so let's let her have the $200 worth of phone calls. A little bit lower.
Lower. You've got it all worked out, Diana. The actual number of married men who would ask their mother-in-law to pay the $200 phone bill is 68. It is not lower. Diana. Norma.
Excuse me.
Norma, you got an 8.
Let's change it.
Changing that 8 to a 10. Oh, a little better card.
Oh, a 10. I'm playing a hunch higher. It's against the odds, but I'm going higher.
Oh, going way against the odds. She's got a feeling. She says higher. And she's right.
Dang, let's go lower.
Lower than a king. Yes, the jack.
Fantastic. Let's keep on going. Let's go down.
For the first game of the match, lower than a jack. It is. Wow. Nicely done. We'll set up for game 2, Janice. What prompted you to go so much against the odds with a 10?
A hunch. Always play your hunches. It's what's gotten me through life.
Well, that's a nice way to feel, Norma. Does it get you through junk piles, Norma?
It's gotten me into a lot of trouble.
Game 1 to the challenger, and the question goes to you, Diana, as Janice deals out the same 2 decks of cards. We asked 100 teenage girls who have a steady boyfriend, if your parents told you you could never see your boyfriend again, would you see him anyway? How many teenage girls said they would defy their parents and continue to see him anyway?
Yes, a lot of them would. A lot of them would, because they'd feel they can't tell me who to go with, and I've been going with them a long time, and they would think that they would owe them loyalty. I say 72.
72 would defy their parents and continue to see him.
No way, Jim. My husband's a teacher, and I have more faith in the teenage girls of today. It's lower.
Did you say lower?
They're going to listen to their parents.
The actual number of teenage girls who would continue to see their boyfriend anyway is 99. It is not lower.
Oh, I needed that one.
That is without doubt the most depressing answer I've ever gotten from a 99 would defy their parents. Wow.
Diana, good card.
You are starting with a 6.
I think I'll change it.
Changing the 6 to a
4. Better. Okay. Higher, please.
Higher than a 4.
Okay,
yes, a 10.
That's better. I'm going to go ahead and go on because I need this game. I'm going to say lower.
Taking a risk, lower than a 10. And you get a king after the 10. And Norma gets a free chance to play a jack.
Okay, jacks. Let's go lower.
Lower than a jack. It is a 4.
Okay, let's go higher, Jim.
Higher than a 4. No, please. That time intuition failed, Norma. And the question goes to you as we fill in the spaces. Norma, we asked 100 married women, have you ever caught your husband in a lie? How many women said they have caught their husband in a lie?
Well, you're not saying what kind of a lie, and all husbands lie, let's face it, even something minor.
Really?
So let's go for a higher number. Let's go for 83.
83, yes. Diana?
Oh, I don't think that many wives would say they caught their husbands. I've got to say a little bit lower.
Lower. The actual number of married women who have caught their husband in a lie is 61. It's lower, Diana.
Okay, let's keep that 4 and let's go higher.
Higher than a 4. Yes, a 6.
Okay. I've got to go. I really have to go. Higher.
Higher than a 6? No, another 6. It is not higher. And again, Norma, a free chance to play off the jack.
Okay, let's go with lower. Let's see what we get.
Lower than a jack, we get a 4.
Okay, if you throw another 3 at me, well, let's go for a higher number.
Higher than a 4, a jack.
Okay. Ah, that's a lot of face cards, so let's go lower.
Lower than a jack.
Yes, sir.
A 7.
Let's freeze.
Freezing it, needing 1 card for the championship. Can she do it? We'll find out right after we take time out for this. In the middle of game 2, Diana, the champion, needs 4 cards. Norma, the challenger, needs just 1 to become the new champion on Card Sharks. Question 3. Diana, we asked 100 men, if you could, would you trade your body for Mr. Universe's body?
Oh.
How many men said they would not you, lady. That's no. How many men said they would trade their body for Mr. Universe's body?
I don't think so, because I think Mr. Universe is too muscly and too much.
You're a nice lady, Diana.
Thank you. I would say only about 32.
32 would trade with Mr. Universe, Norma.
I think that the number is going to be much lower because I'm going to have to agree. It's just too many muscles in one little space.
The actual number of men who, if they could, would trade their body for Mr. Universe's body is 21.
Okay.
It's lower. Norma.
Let's change it.
She's not even waiting. She wants that
Let's
7
change
chains.
It.
A big change. Ace! For the championship lower, she became the new champion. Wow. Very quickly. Norma, congratulations.
Oh,
Diana.
Thank you.
Thank
it was a pleasure
you.
Being here.
And, of course, you're leaving us with
$200. Thank you very much.
Diana Jarrett. Thank you, Diana. Norma, come on down with me. We'll get set up for the money cards coming up right after this. Back with our champion, Norma. We want to give you the opportunity to play the money cards. They've been dealt out in front of the audience, and here we go. Choice of 2 base cards on the bottom level, and of course, you can change them as you move up. With $200, Norma, you'll start with a 10.
Change it. Bad card
change
for me.
Changing that 10. Mm-hmm. Let's see if we can make a good change. Change it to
an
ace again.
Okay, let's go for a whole shooting match for less, for lower. $200
okay,
for lower.
Let's not have another double ace card.
No, no.
$200 lower than an ace. It
okay.
is a 4. Doubling it to 400.
Shoot the works for higher.
Again, the
Shoot
whole thing.
Shoot it all.
$400 higher. Yes,
okay.
for the king.
Shoot it all higher. I mean, lower. Excuse me. Thank you.
$800 lower than a king. Yes,
oh,
and very much lower.
Okay.
You've cleared the board on the bottom level. $200 more.
Okay, let's keep the 3. Let's go for everything. Let's go for higher.
$1,800.
Yes, let's go for it.
Higher than a 3. Yes, with a jack.
Oh.
$3,600 and a jack.
Okay. Let's shoot it all. I came with nothing. I'll leave with nothing. An ace, a king, a jack. Let's go for lower and let's shoot it all.
Oh, my. You are a gambler.
Let's go.
$3,600 lower than a jack. It is with a deuce. $7,200 and a deuce.
Shall we go for all of it? Yes. All of it and higher.
$7,200 higher. Yes, for the queen. Norma, you are on the brink. I don't know. Your decision. Do you want that queen?
Yes.
$7,200 you must bet. You have 14-4.
Shoot the match. The whole works.
Nothing or $28,800.
Lower.
Lower. Yes! She broke the bank. Everything. Oh, wow. Oh, yeah. That's super. Oh, we're so happy for you. That
That's the first time it's been done.
Oh, it is.
That takes a lot of guts and good cards. Oh, my.
Oh, I'm going to call Japan tonight.
You're going to call Japan?
I'm calling Japan, even with the commercial cost. I've got to call. Wonderful.
And, of course, with the money in the game, Norma, you've just finished up in one game $29,000. That is sensational.
Oh, unbelievable.
You wanted to fly first class? You can almost buy your own airplane now, Norma.
I will. J.A.L.
A great champion, and remember, she's still here. She could do it again. We'll meet a new challenger on our next Card Sharks. Bye-bye for now. Norma, congratulations.
One of our polling groups will receive Morse Electrophonics Disco Jukebox, Dance to Your Favorite Records, 8-track tapes, or AM-FM stereo. Multicolor disco lights respond to the beat of the music. The Disco Jukebox furnished by Morse Electrophonic. And some of our contestants will receive an assortment of exciting Maybelline eyes, face and nail cosmetics featuring new nail color. Protects and colors nails instantly furnished by Maybelline. And you can give Roman Brio men's fragrance gift sets this Christmas. Roman Brio cologne and aftershave available in regular or leather scents. And a selection of Tenti products, the great new building set from Hasbro. With Tenti, it's a snap to be a better builder. And Smooth and Silky by Remington, the electric razor for women that we believe shaves as well as a blade. The Remington Smooth and Silky. This is Gene Wood speaking for Card Sharks, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.